What is going on, everybody? Mike Strauss back with another interview. This time up, got a chance to speak with Liam McGeary again. He is fighting Phil Davis at Bellator 220. Should be an exciting fight. It's a rematch, but I think we could have a different outcome this time. Before we get to that, you guys know you can find my work at bjpenn.com, Low Kick, Cage Side Press, and of course the YouTube channel, Mike Strauss, Mike MMA. Back to my conversation with Liam McGeary. Enjoy. I want to welcome Liam McGeary to the show. We actually got a chance to speak last time you fought, man. What's going on? You're fighting Phil Davis, Bellator 220. You know, this is the first time in your career that you actually are fighting the same guy twice. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct, yeah.
Now, Liam, is anything going to change for you, or is it just business as usual?
Just business as usual, mate. You know, yeah, this is the only way I can look at it.
People are probably expecting this fight to go kind of similar, but I want to know, what round do you plan on knocking him out?
Second.
The second round?
Or even the first.
I was going to say, you plan on playing with him for a little bit?
Well, it'll happen when it happens, but yeah, it's going to be hard for him.
How is everything being? You're still at the Toms River, New Jersey with those guys, right?
No, man. I moved a long time ago from there. I'm in California now training, but I live in Hawaii now.
Oh, wow. All right. Doesn't get much better than that. So have you just been kind of taking taking pieces from all the different camps and making it your own then?
Yeah. You know, I mean, I was in New York for 5-6 years, you know, training under John Danaher, Jason Strout, and training with all those guys on the East Coast. But I'm able to take that, what I've learned from them. And now I've come over here and I'm able to learn from somebody else and add that to my game. And it's just completely changed it all the way around. Like you saw in the King Mo fight.
Yeah, man. I mean, you looked incredible. Would you say that was the best performance of your career?
Yes, definitely.
Was that?
You know, I came in, flew in, and won the top world title quite quickly. You know, so and now that was what you knew back then, but now it's just a completely different monster.
Yeah, no, you definitely looked incredible in your last time out. That was Bellator 213. That was December of 2018. You looked really good in that fight, man. And that's kind of what, like you mentioned, when you won the title, people thought that's kind of what the next step was going to be. But here you are, and you mentioned the title. Is that what you have your mindset on again, Liam? Is that what you want? You want that belt back?
Yes, of course. Yeah, I definitely want the belt back. But you know, I have to go along the right path first, you know, and Phil Davis is stood in front of me right now, so that's the person who was going to get a beating.
For sure. Now, obviously, you know, you've been in there with Phil before, so you felt his power. You know, you kind of know what to expect. He's going to want to take you down. You know, you're comfortable with it going down there, but ideally, I'm thinking you want to keep the fight standing. But without revealing your game plan, man, have you been spending a lot of time working on your takedown defense?
Yes, I have. You know, I've definitely been fixing the holes that were in my game, and now everything's fixed, and now we're just adding on and making things better now.
Personally, I always thought you were one of the most exciting guys that Bellator's had. I mean, that run that you had in 2014, I mean, you were just knocking fools out. No one was getting out of the first round. It was pretty incredible, man. And, you know, I think that you're 36 years old, man. So, you know, you're really not too...
Cheers for reminding me.
Hey, man, I'm 39. You're not too old in MMA standards still, especially in the light heavyweight division. So you feel like we could still get a run here?
I do. Remember, my record is only 13-3. Yes, I am 36, but I started this game... I started at 1-0 or 2. I don't even remember. 3-0, I think it was, when I came to Bellator. So... it's all I've ever done is, and all I've ever known is Bellator, and I've grew up through Bellator. So most people don't even get their shout out to these big organizations till you're at actually my record. You know, they usually have 15, 16 fights behind them, and then they'll get called up, you know?
Yeah.
But no, it's still, I've got the, you've still got the best for me to come yet.
Yeah, well, I'm looking forward to it, man. Like I said, that run in 2014 you had, if you can get back to that, man, people are in trouble, and Ryan Bader is going to have his hands full, that's for sure. Well, I want to thank you for your time,
yes,
man. Give you a few minutes here. Shout out your team, coaches, whatever you'd like, brother. Floor is yours, Liam.
Thank you, man. I just want to thank everyone at the Huntington Beach Show, my training center, Paul Herrera, Tiki Gosen, all my training partners. Thanks for your help for another great, successful camp. And it's time to do work in a few more days.
All right. Well, I'm excited, man. That's one of the fights I have circled on the calendar. So thank you for your time, man, and best of luck to you.
Thanks, buddy. Cheers, man.